so I'm just thinking. It's crazy. It's crazy hard to find a training partner for me. It's cool that you're finding a competitive community.
Yeah. I mean,
not selectively. And then Dragon Ball, when the rollback happened is when everything changed. Both when the beta happened and when the quote-unquote real deal happened. It changed a lot of the dynamic from both the console side and the PC side. For the little bit I've been on PC at that time, now a pretty good amount of time, to see the differentiation between the involvement and communication of both sides of the community. Well, for now, they seem open until they prove to be something other than helpful, I'd say, to ride the wave. You know what? Yeah. Actually, you know what? Yeah, it makes sense to just try and ride it out. And then when things change, then that's when I can kind of change with it. Still trying to stick with DBZ until CEO. I want to have at least one offline event before I move on. Well, besides Dragon Ball, what other games are you playing now? Tekken, Street Fighter? I still play Dragon Ball on the side. I just haven't been playing it as much because there haven't been any online tournaments for me to warrant picking it back up predominantly to go and play. And if they do, it always conflicts with my schedule. Usually those TOs that do have something going on for those events, they usually come see me in order to help with the promotional process because they don't have all the connections in place. So I just do whatever it is I do, and then it just works. But then on top of that, I'm still going to keep hosting. I've just been taking a break from hosting right now, so that way I can turn my focus towards trying to compete again. Because I originally wanted to do a competing focus going into 2024, since a lot of these communities didn't really think I was doing much of anything, so let me go on ahead and just leave the TO scene for the most part, since I'm not doing much, and just go back to doing me. And win this tournament like I've been trying to do for years and a day. So that way all the stuff and trying to be good at games can matter. And then I can have a sense of contentment. Glad to see you vibing something else. Yeah, like, trust me, I wanted that to be Dragon Ball for so long and for so many years that I put so much work and time and effort into mastering my craft and understanding of so many different matchups, but not the people. And then the training, which was good at first, and then it just fell off because of so many varied people's opinions about playing online, training online, taking online quote-unquote seriously, or playing me and then wanting to play online again, and then don't go through with it because of A, B, C. Then me never getting what it is I wanted with all the one-on-ones I sought, both outside of the rollback and then leading up to it, when I finally had my wish list for everybody in the world I wanted to fight. Because I had a wish list for years for everybody I wanted to fight, because I needed to see if I can actually beat these people, just for my own satisfaction. Because I can't say I'm that good or that I'm good, period, unless I beat people that are good, or if I can contest them. And it just felt like I was constantly being denied over and over again because of either being on PlayStation or being a PlayStation person. And then I finally made the jump over here to PC, so now I can have the best of both worlds. And I'm still being denied matches. And then the rollback shit happened, where finally I get matches with all of these EU players and Mexico players and UK players, and just everything was so much better than all the shit I've known for years here on the East Coast. And it suddenly just didn't matter anymore. And I stand by it in a day that it's just like the non-East Coast players are just bullshitting. Like, EU players, non-NA players always seek matches all over the place, and a lot of them are really good. They don't care about the whole elitist thing or trying to gatekeep people. They just want to smoke with anybody at any time, and they happen to be friendly people about it. Well, at least 80% of the ones I've seen so far. But with East Coast, it's like you only want to play with a select group of people over and over and over again, and then you whine and bitch about everybody not in that same group. Or there always has to be some type of proving method, or you always have to prove something. A man gets tired of needing to prove something to children that don't care from the beginning. And it rinses and repeats, be it from Chicago or the New Yorkers from HOC or what, people from the Bronx, whatever it is. Like, I just want to get good or get better and not be having like my own proficiency held against me because it's something that I can never have because I can never be quote unquote as good as you. And I never will be unless I'm fighting you or people like you, which you keep denying me of for whatever reason. It's always something. And the one thing I valued about dealing with the EU, the US, the UK people is because it was never an issue.
Gets a little more connected, but a little
They
further
want more
apart.
variety of people to
But
fight.
then
That way they're not just
there
fighting
comes
other
the moment
UK European-based
to be more
players.
human. Thank you for calling Amica Insurance.
Hey, I was just in an accident.
And
Don't
then
worry,
between
we'll be
like
taken care of.
not getting the matches I want,
We understand that
not getting
looking out
any
for
of
children
the
isn't new or
or a lot
groundbreaking.
of the matches on my wish list of 1v1s,
Empathy is our best
and then the
policy.
rollback finally getting here in full for PC and PlayStation, so now I can embrace my whole thing in order to fight people across the globe on PlayStation and PC, and suddenly it just got shit on because now PS4 is irrelevant. PS5 has to be the wave, even though PS5 has this buggy outline to it. And both the platforms are now just separate. I just don't want anything more to do with this game now. So now I'm just forced to move on. I mean, when I tell you I was so fucking pissed, I was just so irreversibly pissed off. Because it was just like 5, 6 years of playing the game just flushed down the drain because no PS5, no access, no way, no pot to piss. And then I'm here on PC. No training partners, no tournaments on PC like that. And no players to fight that are just on PC exclusive. And so I ask myself, why the hell am I here? Why do. Like, I'm literally sitting here suffering on this game that I want to love with nobody that I can fight to prove to myself that I'm actually good at this game because of where I came from, not who I am. You know what? Just fuck this community. And so I decided to just go on ahead and just go. Yeah, rollback was like the last straw for me, but I knew that I would be mad at myself if I didn't do an offline for myself. Definitely. do what you can in order to try and hit up the online as CEO, and then see where your scope is. I wish you good luck out there.